welcome the battle for Karnataka. That's right, the big state that's going to the polls in a few weeks from now, and the first definitive opinion poll that you've been waiting for on an election that could set the tone for the 2019 general elections. The India Today Karvy Insights poll is coming to you in a moment from now. With me is my colleague Rahul Kawal, and we've got special guests. Joining me now is GVL Narasimha Rao, now the Member of Parliament.
Expert cephologist.
Former cephologist, now Neta.
Now Neta, Member of Parliament of the Bharatiya Janata Party, the man from Karvy. Mr. Channa, you're the one whose head is on the block. If things go wrong, you get the blame. If we get it right, we'll take all the credit. Also joining us is Danish Ali of the Janata Dal Secular, Manisha PM, Senior Political Analyst. Now, let's first go to the headlines, though, this evening.
What we'll do, Rajdeep, is take our viewers through the methodology that's been used in the conduct of this poll. Remember, this is the first definitive opinion poll for Karnataka. So far, there's been a lot of chatter about Karnataka, but no authoritative signals from the ground. This poll was conducted by Karvy Insights for India Today in all the 224 constituencies of Karnataka. This is crucial. The pollsters actually went into every single constituency. We sampled, Rajdeep, a total of 27,919 voters. Also, the poll was conducted between the 17th of March and the 5th of April. That's the time this poll was conducted.
Okay, so therefore, as you can see, this poll has gone to each and every of the 224 constituencies of Karnataka. Am I correct? This is not a random sample. You've gone to all the constituencies.
We have gone to all the 224 constituencies, and we have covered a close to 120 plus sample in all those constituencies.
Okay, so it's a very large sample. And remember, of course, this is a very difficult state to predict, because it's not just the Congress and the BJP, but there is a third factor, the JDS, which could also play a key role. But let's turn to the first key graphic that we have for you. We are going to start with the ratings of the Chief Minister and take a look at what the India Today Karvy opinion poll is now saying in the Chief Ministerial stakes. Performance of Chief Minister Siddaramaiah, very good 10%. Good 28%, average 31%, poor 20%, very poor 9%, can't say 2%. Among groups, and Rahul, this is interesting because Karnataka, the caste factor is going to play a big role. Among Lingayats, performance 30% thought Siddaramaiah's performance was good or above average. Among Vokaligas, 32, among Brahmins, 33. But as you go up the order, Kurbas is 42, Edigas, 39, Dalits. And remember, one survey says 19% of Karnataka now is Dalit, is 45%. Just one more graphic before you take over, Rahul. Performance of the Congress government. Very good was just 8%. Good, 27%. Average, 31%. Poor, 21%. Very poor, 11%. Can't say 2%. So overall, Siddaramaiah is getting what you would describe as an average rating, not particularly doing very strongly, but not doing as badly as some Karnataka governments have done in the past. Because if you look at Congress government's performance, very good, good. Take a look at very good, good of the Congress government's performance. It's not as bad as it would, because as you go down, it is roughly an average performance is what we are getting.
Not really, Rajdeep, because 38% of the respondents think that Siddaramaiah has either been good or very good. 5 years in a state like Karnataka, which is known to have a five-year cycle, that's not bad.
Not bad, but you see, you would normally expect it to be over 50% for you to say there is no anti-incumbency. What these early trends are showing is that there is a measure of anti-incumbency against the Chief Minister. Would that be right?
I would not agree for that anti-incumbency, because over the last few months, Siddaramaiah has actually neutralized the anti-incumbency by some recent steps that he has taken. For example, Kannada language. For example, the Karnataka flag. So if you look at
But normally, chief ministers who retain power should be over 50%. You would expect 50% to be good or very good.
Yeah, I would say two things. Both the things that you said, he's been doing it for the last many years. Remember when the metro came, it became Nama Metro, no Hindi signs there. So all these antics that you're calling last minute anti-incumbency battling measures have been there as an element of his thing. What I would have wanted to see, that the very good and good combined also should have been close to a 45%, if not a 50%. And that's my real worry. It means people are saying, okay, but not quite sure that this is a thumping majority. However, when you spread it across castes, there is a different story. That's much of what he's doing in terms of the Kannada language or the flag has nothing really to do with the Kurbas or the Dalits. So he may be doing something else there, which we don't know.
The Bhagya schemes that he has launched over the last 2 years, they have resulted in a good, good.
So Rajdeep, let's introduce the guests who are joining us from Bengaluru as well. One of the top political analysts out of Karnataka, Sandeep Shastri, is joining us in our Bengaluru studio. R.K. Upadhyay is our pandit for the Karnataka elections. He's joining us from there as well. Also with us is B.K. Hariprasad. B.K. Hariprasad is a senior leader of the Congress Party. Welcome, sir. I want to go across now to Prakash Javadekar. Prakash Javadekar is the Union HRD Minister. He's the man in charge of Karnataka. He's responsible, apart from battling all the CBSE fires, also responsible for helping the BJP win in Karnataka. Prakash Javadekar is joining us from Bengaluru. That's where he is. Mr. Javadekar, our first set of data that we've put out so far seems to suggest that the Chief Minister is not faring too badly. A 38% approval rating. 38% of the respondents thinking he's either been good or very good. So it's not as if you are going into this battle with acute anti-incumbency facing the Congress.
Mr. Javadekar, can you hear us? Let's try and... Mr. Javadekar, can you hear us?
Yes, I can.
Okay, Mr. Javadekar, you know, Rahul was asking you about the anti-incumbency factor. And let me put another graphic to that. Yes, there is a measure of anti-incumbency, but not as high as we've seen in other states.
If
I ask you, in our survey, we asked who is best suited to become the Chief Minister of Karnataka. Siddaramaiah had 33%, B.S. Yediyurappa 26%, H.D. Kumaraswamy 21%, Jagdish Shettar 4%, Anand Kumar Hegde 3%, Sadanand Gowda 2%, and Parmeshwar 1%. Siddaramaiah, sir, is still the preferred candidate for chief ministership, but the anti-incumbency that exists is perhaps there, but not as sharp as some would have thought. Your responses, do you believe that there is greater anti-incumbency than what our survey is suggesting?
Yes. Absolutely, this is election of anti-incumbency, and as I am touring, I have traveled 18 districts and I have seen, and the response what we are getting in Amit Shah tour and Prime Minister's tour, I have seen it myself and talked to so many cross sections. The poor and everybody is angry. There is a farm distress. There is a poor are angry upon Congress. They want good governance, Modi-like, and they want good things to happen to Karnataka. Bengaluru city, which was a garden city, known as garden city, now has become garbage city. A beautiful city is now a pothole city. City of lakes is now city of lakes on fire. And the everything, the IT city, has now known more as a crime city. So it's a complete Gunda Raj, lawlessness, and everything has collapsed, governance has collapsed. And therefore it's a, so people are saying that Siddha Sarkara, because he's advertising as Siddha Sarkara. So Siddha Sarkara bid the Karnataka. That is what they are saying. And therefore people are coming in large number to BJP, and therefore people are saying Sarkara Badalisi, BJP Gelesi. So what does this mean is people want to vote for change, and they want BJP to
really
bring
in. Prakash, you've been practicing some of your Kannada on the campaign trail, but this data also suggests that some of the moves that the tactical maneuvers that the Chief Minister has made in the build-up to the election seem to be yielding some traction on the ground. Because on the issue of whether the Lingayat demand was a major issue, 52% of our respondents felt that that is indeed a major issue in this election. Now, the Lingayats, for the longest time, have been traditional supporters of the Bharatiya Janata Party. If generally voters feel this is a big issue, does that push the BJP into a box?
That's what, sir. No, actually, it helps us a lot, because what Congress is doing, dividing the society, more importantly, they want to ensure that Yedurappa doesn't become chief minister. So they are stopping one Lingayat leader from becoming chief minister. So everybody understands the ramification. And let me again tell you very clearly that this divisive politics will recoil on Congress and senior leaders. You go to senior leaders of Congress, not in Karnataka, all India also, those who understand this Lingayat politics, they are all cursing Siddaramaiah because he has done this, and this
so
is going
saying
to be
rank.
So there will be more consolidation in favor of BJP.
Okay, you're saying that, but you know, let's be also clear. When we ask the direct question, best suited to become Chief Minister, Siddaramaiah is still ahead of Yediyurappa. So I'm just wondering whether Siddaramaiah is still Raj Chengappa now joining us at the moment. You want to quickly respond to that, and I'll ask Mr. Jawdekar also that. Mr. Jawdekar, you want to respond, and then I'll get Raj to also respond. Do you believe that Siddaramaiah is actually in a direct contest?
Yeah.
Still ahead of Yediyurappa. That Yediyurappa is not seen as the leader that he was in 2008. He's become older, he's more tired, he's gone out of your party, come back in.
No.
He lacks the credibility that Siddaramaiah has.
No, absolutely not. Because it's a complete anti-incumbency, as I said. People are hating this government. 3,500 Kisan suicides, and the whole farm distress is because of Siddaramaiah government policies. And the bad governance they have provided in Bengaluru city is also causing them a lot of heartburns and trouble. And let me tell you, because he is chief minister, so his name is daily appearing, so 32% is there today, but your anti-incumbency index shows very clear trend against Congress, against Siddaramaiah government, and therefore this will change within next 15 days also, you see. And today also, as per our estimate and our judgment and our surveys, we are much, much ahead than Congress.
Minister, one more question on the issue of the Kaveri judgment. When people were asked whether this will benefit the Congress, 49% saying yes. On the issue of Siddaramaiah's handling of the drought, 49% saying satisfied or very satisfied. On the issue of Rahul Gandhi's temple visits, 42% saying it will help the Congress. A lot of the dots in this election, when you add them up, seem to be signaling that the winds are blowing in Karnataka at this time in a tight fight in the Congress's favor. What's your strategy to fight back from here?
No, I don't subscribe to this. I'll tell you, it is not the strategy to fight back, because we are taking strategy to take us forward. We have already got lead in the whole scenario, and we are getting more lead because what has happened, one by one, you go to Tumkur district, 11 seats, people are struggling because there is no water. Because they were promised 24 TMC water, and only 4 TMC water is available. Go to Davangiri, the city of 7 lakh people, there is water comes for, drinking water comes for 1 hour in 10 days. So everybody has to depend on tanker. So this is what the situation is prevailing actually in Karnataka all over. And so people are absolutely not happy on this ground. We have helped, as a central government, we have helped coconut growers and arcanut growers. We have increased their prices. And the Siddaramaiah government has done nothing.
Believe it, there, Minister.
When I was in Davangiri, they were telling farmers that when Siddaramaiah,
Let me leave it there. It's clear that you believe anti-incumbency and unfulfilled promises is going to be what is going to be your theme over the next 4 weeks. I presume Prime Minister Modi will also travel. and therefore
thank you.
We will Prakash Javadekar, thank you very much, sir, for joining us here.
Yes.
You are the man in charge of the BJP's campaign, but let's go right around the table and to Karnataka, where the Congress has to respond. The early trends that we are getting clearly show that the Sitaramaiya factor is a factor. He is the chief minister, and that is a benefit. Raj Chengappa, very quickly, then we'll get the Congress also in.
Well, I'm not surprised. I mean, he has run a good campaign so far. He's been decisive on hot button issues. He has split the BJP's real core base, which is the Lingayats, particularly Mr. Yedurappa's core base. He has, you know, done sufficient maneuvers to win back some of that. His real weakness has been the Vokaligars, as we've noticed, where he's not been able to make a significant dent. But what he's done is built a coalition of backward classes, the scheduled castes and scheduled tribes. That seems to be bringing him the numbers, and he split the Lingayats. And it's surprising that, you know, given the fact that Karnataka, barring 40 years ago, has always voted against the government in power, for him at this stage to be still looking good, I think, as Rahul was saying, the winds are showing some direction. Whether that will gather momentum in the next month and turn out to be a surprise victory for the Congress, because it hasn't happened for so long, is to be seen as yet.
But all this has simply not worked. Whatever Mr. Raj Chengappa says hasn't delivered, hasn't worked, because 33% preference rating for a sitting incumbent chief minister is nothing short of being a disaster. It's even if you consider this to be a 3 horse race, you have less than 1/3 of the popularity, people asking you to continue. So this is actually Siddaramaiah himself is pulling down his party. Mm-hmm. This is a Rajdeep, in the sporting parlance, this is a men's doubles championship. It's not Siddaramaiah versus Yedurappa versus Kumaraswamy. It is a team. It is men's. It's three teams which are in play. Yedurappa, Narendra Modi ji, one team. Rahul Gandhi, Siddaramaiah, another team. Devegowda, Kumaraswamy in one team.
Okay.
And we win hands down.
Okay. I want to go across now.
Yes. It's a men's doubles team. Congress ministers, two senior Congress leaders, DK Shivkumar, heavyweight from Karnataka, state's energy minister, joining us also on this broadcast. BK Hariprasad, another Congress leader from Karnataka. I want to go across to Mr. Shivkumar first, because the one big challenge is that Karnataka, like used to be said about Punjab, has a 5-year cycle. 5 years later, voters tend to throw out that party which has been in power. Is that going to be a problem? That even though Siddaramaiah hasn't done too badly, there's that 5-year itch, where after 5 years, voters generally want the incumbent party out. How big a problem is that, Mr. Shivkumar?
See, as far as Karnataka is concerned, there is no incumbency factor in Karnataka Congress government, because the entire section has been looked upon. Whatever has been promised has been delivered. This is a very peaceful state. The people of Karnataka are highly politically matured people. We have delivered whatever we have promised, and the entire section has been happy. You've been watching from the past 5 years. There is no even a single disturbance in any community. We have seen that. We have taken all sections of the society together. This is a very prosperity state. Looking at this, the Prime Minister of this country, Mr. Narendra Modi, you remember 1 year back, he had brought his entire team. He made a Pravasi Bharatiya Divas. He called the entire world. He called the investors of this country and the investors of the world to come to Karnataka, and a Pravasi Bharatiya Divas was being made. He said that here is a government, here is a state which has given good performance, good
Mr.
land,
Shivkumar,
good education, good use, good power.
Mr. Shivkumar, let me give you some hard facts.
Yes.
Let's look at the survey. Today is the day for the survey. Karnataka decides our opinion.
Please, please.
Poll says on state of corruption, significantly decreased 6%, somewhat decreased 16%, same 32% said also somewhat increased, significantly increased said 16. So 48%, one in every two are saying corruption has increased. So, you know, there are, when you go into the specifics of some of these areas, you have much to answer for. Now, the Prime Minister comes to Karnataka and calls your Chief Minister Mr. 10%. And 48% of the poll is saying corruption is an issue which has either increased somewhat or significantly increased. Does that not trouble you? The other data points do suggest there is an element of anti-incumbency.
See,
corruption is an issue which has either increased somewhat or significantly increased.
See, it is a shame on the Prime Minister of this country, because it is his own country. He can't defame a state which is giving one of the highest revenues in this country. The highest export revenue has been from Karnataka, and he has been presenting in Karnataka all the way. The entire world is looking. Karnataka and Bangalore is the door for it. When that is the case, just for a political power, he can't defame Karnataka. Karnataka has a very big history on it, and the entire world is looking through Karnataka and Bangalore. When such is the case, for just for political angle, the Prime Minister call this is a percentage state.
Mr. Shivkumar, that this is a political angle.
Why did he not take action?
The data suggests otherwise. Now, I want to put this question to B.K. Hariprasad, because you see the politics of Karnataka very closely. When voters were asked, will the 10% commission charge against the Chief Minister benefit the BJP? 52%. Mr. Hariprasad, the respondents said yes. 52% of the respondents felt that this 10% commission charge will help the BJP. That wouldn't be the case if people thought that the Siddaramaiah government wasn't corrupt.
Well, Rahul, let me go back to what Mr. Javadekar has said. These catchy slogans will not work in Karnataka. Already people are fed up with
this
the slogans what Mr. Narendra Modi had given in the past. I'm coming to you. Just hold on. I'm talking about Mr. Javadekar's reaction to your survey. The confluence of the opinion, mood and the pulse of the people of Karnataka is a different thing. But as far as the polls are concerned, we'll have to wait, because different companies also had this survey. And as far as your question is concerned about the corruption, Prime Minister is yet to open his mouth on Rafael deal. Prime Minister is yet to open his mouth on Choksi and Nirav Modi. And he has no business to come down to Karnataka and speak of 10%. If he is so confident that Karnataka government is corrupt, he should initiate action against the Chief Minister. It is nothing but a rhetoric, and that's it. Nothing else.
Okay. Let's come to the numbers again. What is coming out across the early numbers, and Professor Shastri and maybe the experts who will not be divided on political lines can tell us. Professor Shastri and Mr. Upadhyay, your first reactions. Are you seeing a caste split? As we see in the survey, Siddaramaiah does even better among Kurubas, among Dalits, among the backward caste. His problem is coming among Lingayats even today, and among Vokaligas. Do you believe that this is the nature of Karnataka elections? This is to both of you, starting with you, Mr. Shastri, first, that you are going to see an ever sharpening caste split. Karnataka is split along caste lines, and our survey seems to confirm that.
Yes, Rajdeep. First, I would say your survey findings are not surprising to me, because on the ground, this clearly seems to be the trend. The state has been divided because of the nature of politics strongly on caste lines. And it's interesting to see that when you look at the different social groups, the type of support for Siddaramaiah, for Yediyurappa, clearly goes along caste lines. I would also draw your attention to one dimension of your poll, which shows that either in terms of the support for the Chief Minister or the government or the rating of the Chief Ministers, you have quite a high percentage saying average. And average could mean either this way or that way, which could also imply people are at this stage undecided of where to go and are still waiting as part of the campaign to take a final decision.
They're just uninspired. Or maybe they're uninspired. Karnataka has been given a choice between a Chief Minister who went to jail not too long ago on corruption charges, and you've got a Siddaramaiah who's being openly accused by the Prime Minister of being Mr. 10%, and you've got the Janata Dal Secular of Devagowda, which is an octogenarian. I'm just wondering, Mr. Upadhyay, do you believe people of Karnataka feel we have no choice? This poll is showing that there is no great enthusiasm for any party. No party is getting strong backing. There's no strong anti-incumbency, but there isn't even a positive mood in favor of Mr. Siddaramaiah. That's the sense I'm getting, that this is a very thanda election in terms of choice of options for the people.
Rajiv, the point is that, as your survey shows, that Siddaramaiah government has not been great in terms of corruption. So, one in two are already saying that this government has also been corrupt. It's true that Yediyurappa got to jail and he doesn't have a very great image and people don't see him as a, you know, clean person. But then Siddaramaiah has not been any different. So the whole issue is about, I think Siddaramaiah has been able to give a stable government. I think that's one of his biggest achievements, because between 2004 and 2013, Karnataka had unstable governments. We had two coalition governments followed by, you know, three of the BJP, and, you know, so there was a total anarchy. So to that extent, Siddaramaiah has been able to give a stable government. That is one of his biggest achievements. And then I think two of his flagship programs are Anna Bhagya and Kshira Bhagya, you know, where distribution of subsidized rice and subsidized milk. This is, you know, across the state, it has helped farmers. So that is, I think that will stand him in good stead. Probably that is because of the reasons why, right, you know, he could still be.
I think it's a myth.
He might be able to do
better. Because you haven't seen, in Tamil Nadu, we have seen when Dr. Jayalalitha went into polls, it was visible through the surveys that she was seen as a pro-poor lady, as a pro-poor chief minister. You don't get that kind of a signal from this poll. Because this is a poll where people are completely disillusioned with the government.
Well, well, there's no sign. I think disillusion would be a very strong word to use.
Siddaramaiah is already running for a second seat. He's running away to a seat which is dominated by his caste. So he's not confident about winning his own seat.
But that, is not due to the fear of BJP. He's running away from his own seat because of the fear of the JDS.
Who are seen as the factor that will bring the point Mr. Upadhyay made. Between 2004 and 13, Karnataka had unstable governments, partly because the JDS was in, you know, was the deciding factor for a while. Then you had a BJP government with three chief ministers. At least you have finally a chief minister who's provided 5 years of rule. And if they come back to you, then you will again, if you hold the reins to power, then there'll be indecision. So you are the ones who'll have the challenge in the days ahead.
Rajdeep, first of all, let me be very plain. We, JDS has a consistent position. We don't believe these opinion polls, because opinion polls never do justice to the small parties, regional parties like JDS. I don't know the numbers, what you are going to show, but I do remember in last election, Rahul was conducting show. You can have the footage. You started us showing JDS will get 13 seats. And when result came, we got 40 seats. I don't know what your outcome is today. So, 3 times more what opinion poll shows. So, I think whatever you are going to show in today's opinion polls, okay, at least it so, should okay. be three
the,
times.
The JDS will have a crucial role to play, but what will that role be? Will it be on the margins or will they be front and center? We'll try and delve into that when we come back on the other side of a very quick break. We've got many key ministers, both at the center and in the state, will be joining us. We've got some of the sharpest political minds who track Karnataka very closely. Our coverage continues on the other side of a very quick break. Stay with us. Welcome back. You're watching our continuing coverage of the Big India Today, Karvy Insights Karnataka Opinion Poll, the first definitive, exhaustive opinion poll conducted in every constituency of Karnataka. Before we move any further, a quick recap of the ground that we've covered so far. We asked first whether people were satisfied with the performance of the Siddaramaiah government. What did they think of their chief minister? When this question was asked, about 38% of the respondents felt his performance had either been good or very good. 31% put the chief minister in the average category, and 29% thought his performance had been either poor or very poor. The next question we asked respondents in Karnataka was, who's best suited to be the next chief minister of Karnataka? This, of course, shows which man is in pole position to be the state's next chief minister. When this question was asked, Chief Minister Siddaramaiah came out right at the top. Here is the data for the top pick to be Chief Minister of Karnataka. Siddaramaiah with the highest approval ratings, coming in at 33%. Coming in at number two, former Chief Minister B.S. Yedurappa, back now in the BJP fold, projected as their chief ministerial candidate, but unable to beat Siddaramaiah in the popularity sweepstakes. That's really where the popularity sweepstakes stand. Coming in at number three is H.D. Kumaraswamy of the Janata Dal Secular at 21%. Let's now come to the question that we shall be discussing in this part of our broadcast. We asked respondents what they thought of the various issues that have been heard about in the build-up to polling day. And the first and the one issue that's been spoken of the most is the issue of Lingayats. When people were asked, and here remember I'm not talking just about the Lingayats, when people were asked across categories if they thought the Lingayat issue was a big issue, 52% of the respondents said yes, 28% said no. So Rajdeep, it's very clear that even outside the Lingayat community, more than half the respondents in Karnataka think that the Lingayat issue is a key issue for this election, Rajdeep.
You know, that is the interesting issue that I want to turn to, because that has been the game changer in the last month in terms of creating some element of confusion, some believe, in the ranks of the BJP. 17% of the population of Karnataka, Lingayats, Mumbai, Karnataka, the dominant area for the BJP, dominated by Lingayats. Do you believe Yediyurappa has somewhere at least created confusion in the BJP ranks, or do you believe the Lingayats will remain solidly with the party that they've backed over the last decade or so?
No. Both parties have tried this confusion strategy. People forget that in the Vukkalikas, S.M. Krishna, the chief minister of the Congress party, is now with the BJP. That move was engineered by Shobha Karlanje herself, sitting in Chikmagalur when this move happened at the Belur Mutt precincts. However, Yeddy has taken it to another level. So while we can talk of development, governance, etc., what has happened in Karnataka, therefore, is clear-cut caste politics and hoping somewhere that there will be a tadka smattering of community-based polarization.
Your survey was done after the announcement was made by Siddaramaiah. But before the fact, several mutts of Karnataka have come out in support of Siddaramaiah. Am I correct?
That's right. That happened only last week, while our fieldwork finished on 5th of April.
So there is that one factor. Sandeep Shastri, do you see any impact of the fact that there are a few important mutt leaders who have come out in support of what Siddaramaiah has done? Do you believe that this Lingayat factor is a factor which could create confusion in the BJP ranks? There are about 60 to 70 seats in Karnataka where Lingayats make a difference.
Rajdeep, the fact that 52% say it makes a difference, I think, is important. Because if you look at the last two elections, the Lingayat vote has strongly been with the BJP. Opinion polls have suggested that it was as high as 70 to 80%. And if the Congress were to make even a small dent in that monolith, which seemed to have gone in favor of the BJP, KJP, or the BJP alone in 2003, I think that would make a very big difference in a tight election. If the Congress is able to make that small breach in the Lingayat vote, which is now with the BJP, which was earlier with the BJP, I think it can make a significant difference. And that's the whole idea which Siddaramaiah came up with.
Move because of the seers speaking out in favor of the Congress?
Yes, it will.
To what extent?
That we don't know. If you go to the streets, people, or in the rural area especially, people say, they will tell you a week towards the election. So they don't say. That really means, therefore, that political preferences may be changing. This was tried, as I said, by the BJP. But
This is a strategy that has completely boomeranged. And Siddaramaiah is on the back foot. He's running away from this topic. We challenge him to make this an electoral issue.
Why is Mr. Yediyurappa silent on this?
We have made our position clear. This is purely a political and an electoral stunt which has misfired, and that's why he's really gone back on this. He knows that other minorities whom he has wooed for 5 years, even they have developed doubts about Siddaramaiah and Congress party, and he's scared of losing his own support.
BJP has realized that they are going to lose Karnataka. That is why.
And what
Congress did mistake of late, they are realizing that they may get some benefit or not in Karnataka after this Lingayat issue. That is a different case. But they have realized that the BJP is making this issue in the Hindi belt. All their spokesperson are thinking that
Congress wants to divide Hindus. Congress wants to divide Hindus. That's why what GVL has said is true, that Congress is not debating now much on the Lingayat issue.
Okay, BK Hari Prasad, very quickly on that, and then I want to go to Mr. Upadhyay to understand how many seats will this make a difference on in his view. But BK Hari Prasad, do you believe that the Lingayat issue is something that you only did to create confusion in the BJP ranks? You knew that you can't get it through. You can't give Lingayat minority status without Centre's approval. This was only to create confusion.
Rajdeep, probably people in your studio doesn't know the history of Lingayat. There are two sections in the Lingayat. One is Lingayat and the other one Veerashaivas. This controversy or the dispute is as old as 800-year-old dispute. And as long as your opinion polls are concerned, it is not just but Lingayats alone, because on the law and order issue and the social schemes what we have given, that has given us a lot of hope in this election. And as far as the Lingayats are concerned, let me make it very clear to Mr. Rao from the BJP, the BJP is not fighting in 224 seats. They are only fighting in 170-75 seats, because in the six districts of Karnataka, BJP has no presence. It is the JDS which has got a stronghold in these districts,
and they expect that they will.
Please. I know you didn't.
No, we won.
You are one minute, there is a point. No, 1 minute. Mr. Upadhyay, would I be right?
Interrupt you.
Mr. Upadhyay, would I be right?
Just allow me to speak.
No, you allow me to speak.
Let me complete. And they are talking of the law and order. In the past 7 years, both Congress and Janata Dal have ruled, except 5 years of BJP. We have ruled. Even in the 7 years, there were no, even if there is a fake encounters, the death toll was not more than 100. In UP, within a year, there was 1,000 fake encounters. And they are talking of the law and order. As far as the Bangalore city is concerned, they are tarnishing the image of the Bangalore city, because it appears to be one of the most progressive city in the country. Let them come with me.
So what we need to do is take a look at the results of some of the other tactical moves of Chief Minister Siddaramaiah. You know, on the issue, one second. Let's deal with the Kaveri first. The Supreme Court's delivered a judgment on Kaveri. We asked people whether they think this would benefit the Congress. 49% of the respondents saying yes. The Supreme Court's verdict on Kaveri will benefit the Congress. 34% saying no. On the issue of whether the Chief Minister's handling of the drought was found satisfactory, 49% said they were either satisfied or very satisfied. 26% had no reaction, 18% were not satisfied, and 7% were not at all satisfied. But 49% saying they were either satisfied or very satisfied. On the issue of Rahul's temple runs, which have been the issue of much debate, 42% saying the temple runs will help the Congress, 35% saying no. So Rajdeep, all these dots together seem to suggest that Congress has some wind blowing behind it in this election, that what even if Rahul's going to the temple, people seem to be liking it.
That's right, because if you then look at the opinion on the Tipu anniversary, take a look at where the opinions are on the Tipu anniversary, and again here, support the decision, 32%, doesn't matter, 12, don't support the decision, 44%. There is a greater polarization here, but I want to get that point. As you look at all these figures we are giving Mr. Upadhyay, do you believe this point which is now being made that Karnataka is riven by caste? Caste has divided, split Karnataka wide open, whether it's the Lingayat issue, whether it is these other issues, it is all caste preferences that are coming to the fore. And caste will eventually decide this Karnataka election, caste loyalties.
In Karnataka, it is the caste that plays a major role. I'll tell you, it's not Narendra Modi or Amit Shah or Rahul Gandhi that are the deciding factors. It is the caste which will finally decide how the outcome is going to be. As far as the Lingayat issue is concerned, you know, in North Karnataka, at least in about 90 constituencies, they are a major force and they are the deciding voters. And in South, at least in 20, 25, you know, constituencies, they play a major role, which means half of Karnataka is decided by the Lingayats. So Siddaramaiah has taken a big gamble on splitting the Lingayat votes. So whether it's going to benefit the Congress or is it going to boomerang, I think that is a big issue. Because in the last election, if you remember, you know, Yediyurappa had walked out of the BJP, and you know, that is why they lost about 15% of the votes. And Congress was able to win about 42 extra seats by just getting about 2% votes more than what the Congress BJP had got. So now, to ensure that, you know, BJP votes, some percentage of BJP votes comes to Congress, he has done this. Whether it will work in Congress' favor,
so
we'll have to wait and see.
Split a boomerang. I want to put that question to Raj Chingappa first. Will the Lingayat move split the Lingayat votes of the BJP or boomerang on the Congress?
You know, Ramakrishna was my classmate in journalism, so I don't want to differ too much from him. But I think he's made a decisive move. As you very rightly pointed out in the previous elections, the moment Mr. Yediyurappa moved out, the BJP's vote percentage dropped significantly, particularly among the Lingayats. BJP very wisely, whatever the baggage that Mr. Yediyurappa carries, including the taints that he had, which of course the courts have cleared, they took him on and seemed to have consolidated on that front. It was very important for Mr. Siddaramaiah to make a decisive move on that, because he knows that the Vakuligas are consolidating under the JDS. They do not have a really powerful, the Congress doesn't have a really powerful Vakuliga leader. He had to make a dent into the Lingayat vote, because those 3 or 4% could be the decisive factor if he's able to get that.
Is it working or not in your view?
Well, so at the moment it seems to be.
Working, Rajdeep? Working or not? Split or consolidate?
My sense at the moment is that there is an element of confusion. But the Lingayats broadly, particularly Mumbai, Karnataka, remain with the BJP, broadly.
But let's look at it.
The question is, in a tight race.
Significantly, many of their religious leaders have actually openly come out now and endorsed the Congress.
Sandeep Shastri is disagreeing with Rajdeep. Sandeep Shastri wants to come
in.
DK
Shivakumar also hasn't spoken, but I'll quickly, before I come to you, Mr. Shivakumar, let Sandeep Shastri respond. Do you believe really that this Lingayat move has worked? Because look at another move that he has made. Support for the national, for the state flag. 59% are supporting Siddaramaiah's move on the state flag. So he is getting majority support there. No words can't say. So you are playing Kannadiga pride on one side and you are playing caste politics on the other. Has he been able to push the BJP on the defensive?
I think beyond a shadow of doubt, in the last 1 year, it looks as if the Congress has been setting the agenda and the BJP has been responding. And I think, as Ramakrishna just now said and others have been saying, this attempt to drive a wedge in the Lingayat support of the BJP, even if it leads to a small percentage moving towards the Congress, it can make a difference. And let's also remember that the heads of the various Lingayat and Veerashaiva mutts who have supported the Congress, it also reflects the internal dynamics within that community. And that has been very cleverly and shrewdly made use of by the Congress.
Is that disconcerting for the BJP GVL that these mutts are now openly coming out and supporting the Congress?
Not at all. I think the Lingayats have actually, a large section of it has realized that this is a political stunt.
No, the mutts are very important and consequential.
Fine, but that's alone not going to decide how they will vote. I think I would appeal to you, let us not overstate the importance of caste. Caste is certainly important, but it is not everything. You're doing a great disservice, because this is not how India of today is.
So this is not an election.
20 years.
This is not an election.
India.
Why did you make Yediyurappa your leader?
They made Yediyurappa the chief ministerial candidate because of caste only.
Let him speak.
I'm speaking with my own experience as a political analyst, having seen elections for 3 decades. Caste has always been a factor. It is a factor even today. We cannot ignore it. But at the same time, to say you just put this caste together and make some stunt, give some electoral stunts, you win elections, come on, that's not how
they
will look for good governance. They will punish you for non-governance, because of caste.
They brought Mahant to the chief minister's chair.
The BJP may have tried in the past and still hopes to bank on the Lingayats. But the Congress also, what has Siddaramaiah done over the 5 years? The various sops that he's given. He's trying to create what Raj Chengappa once calls a Devraj Arz Plus formula. Looking at backward caste, looking at Dalits and Muslims. The Ahinda formula. You are a Vakuliga. But the fact is, there are Vokaligas today who still see Devagowda as their number one leader, because Vokaligas believe Siddaramaiah hasn't given them space. He's given it to Kurbas, he's given it to Dalits, he's giving it to Muslims, he's giving it to his own caste. To that extent, Congress and BJP are both playing caste card. You're now even playing Kannadiga nationalism or Kannadiga sub-nationalism. You are doing Sam, Dam, Danda, Bhed, anything somehow to win the elections.
See, first I would like to tell you that you are just discussing on the Lingayat issue. This Lingayat issue is not Siddaramaiah's problem. It is the problem of the entire Lingayat, including the demand raised by Mr. Yediyurappa and his team. The entire Lingayat leaders of all the political party, either the JDS, BJP and the Congress party, joined together, gave a representation to the Manmohan Singh and Mr. Sindhe, then the Home Minister of this country.
What your Home Ministry they said at that time, so let's leave Lingayat that on the side.
Focus on the question of the moment. You are also playing your own form of politics.
It is a fact.
There are community leaders now in Karnataka. No, who is the pan Karnataka leader? There is a leader of Mumbai Karnataka, leader of Central Karnataka, leader of Kaveri Delta. Siddaramaiah, is he trying to emerge as a pan Karnataka leader by playing Kannada sub-nationalism? To that extent, do you believe that is your winning card much more than the politics of trying to divide Lingayats? Is Siddaramaiah the number one pan Karnataka leader?
Sure. We agree. Siddaramaiah is the chief minister, is pan-Karnataka leader, who has taken every section of the society together, who has seen that the Karnataka and the Kaveri pride is being taken away, the flag and every issue has been sorted out, taken every to it.
Vokaligas are not with him, Vokaligas are with Devagowda.
No, you and Vokaligas agree to us.
We are there
with the Congress
blunder.
Party.
There are Vokaligas across all parties. There are Vokaliga MPs in my party. I can name them. The Vokaliga MLAs in my party.
It cuts across parties,
to say it's a monolithic, I think it's too simplistic an analysis.
As you can see,
it's a very crude and a raw and a wrong analysis.
BJP would like to make, because Mr. Modi is supposedly their trump card, Mr.
You are undermining the intelligence of the voter. Let me just, we are just talking strategies here.
BJP would like to say that there is a consolidated vote that is there. It's not broken up in caste. As he rightly pointed, why did you bring Yediyurappa? You isolated in some senses the Vokaligas. The Congress's strategy is to ensure one, a certain nationalism, if you'd like to call it in that sense, emerges. He is able to then, apart from the OBC backward classes and the scheduled castes and tribes, also starts trying to get a bit of the Lingayat vote. He knows Vokaligas has a very strong leader.
So it is this coalition.
The battle is between this kind of nationalism that is there, that is consolidation of caste versus this in some sense.
I just want to add to this.
Even Dalits, scheduled castes, don't take them for granted for the Congress. What Siddaramaiah did in last election, making defeat of G. Parmeshwar, the PCC president, who was the claimant for the chief minister's chair, Kurbas voted. Siddaramaiah made his caste vote against G. Parmeshwar, and he was defeated.
He did not allow Parmeshwar to become deputy chief minister.
Dalit did not allow Dalit to become a deputy chief minister, in spite of Congress High Commission.
So some parties would really like to be only about caste. This election to be only about caste. The fact is that Siddha's government has not given farm loan waivers, so there's something happening here. The fiscal deficit is not there. Fiscal prudence has been there. I have been to block level headquarters in Hyderabad, Karnataka area, and I have found that women who are coming out of block and district headquarters have not said that we have not been given the benefits of this scheme or that. So there's certainly something happening which is away from this whole thing about only caste, and those factors have to be looked at.
So what do the vote share and seat share percentages of Karnataka look like? That's the one key question everyone has in their minds. We'll slip into a break. When we come back, we'll show you what the new assembly in Karnataka could look like. The fact is, the BJP seems like a winning machine. It has a certain amount of momentum riding in on the basis of victories in other states. The Congress is currently on the defensive. Can Karnataka be there? Springboard to revival, or will the victory machine led by Modi and Shah just steamroll over the Congress once more? What could the new Karnataka Assembly look like? Rajdeep and I will have those numbers for you when we come back on the other side of a quick break. Stay with us.
He's not speaking like a prime minister. He's a facilitator of the corruption.
Modi ji ke netritva mein ye 20 rajya aaj vikas kar rahe hain. Ab bari Karnataka ki hai.
Modi ji ne kaha 70 saal हिंदुस्तान में कुछ नहीं हुआ. हिंदुस्तान के करोड़ों किसान, मजदूर, छोटे दुकानदार, इन्होंने कुछ नहीं किया.
अरे हम तो जवाब दे देंगे, फट से जवाब दे देंगे. मैं आया हूं कर्नाटक की जनता को जवाब देने, मगर राहुल बाबा हमसे 4 साल का क्या हिसाब मांगते हो? हम आपसे 4 पीढ़ी का हिसाब मांगना चाहते हैं.
Welcome to our special edition, the build-up to the next big election battle of 2018, the battle for Karnataka, which is already being billed as the first semi-final towards the 2019 general elections. Rahul Gandhi crisscrossing the state, Narendra Modi set to visit Karnataka in a week or so. You can expect Karnataka to dominate the national headlines over the next month. The gateway to the south, possibly for the BJP, for the Congress, a chance to get some toehold ahead of the 2019 elections after a series of reverses. Who's winning the battle for Karnataka? Siddaramaiah versus Yediyurappa, or will Devagowda be the spoiler? Tonight, the results of the India Today Karvy opinion poll in a short while from now. Just to tell you, 27,919 interviews conducted across all 224 assembly constituencies surveyed between the 17th of March and the 5th of April. These were the dates when the survey was conducted. Remember, this is the big India Today Karvy opinion poll on what is going to happen in Karnataka. Let's go straight across to Rahul Kaval, who has all the big numbers for us. Rahul, who is winning Karnataka if elections are held today?
That's the one question, Rajdeep, that every single person has had in his mind, and so far there have been no definite clues. This is the first time we are showing you the results of the India Today Karvy Insights Karnataka opinion poll, the first opinion poll off the block in battleground Karnataka. This is what Karvy thinks the new assembly of Karnataka will look like. The Congress projected to bag between 90 and 101 seats. Remember, 112 is the majority figure. Last time the Congress had 122. That tally could drop by about 24 seats. The Bharatiya Janata Party, which picked up 40 seats the last time, expected to double its tally this time between 78 and 86 seats. Far better a performance than the previous elections, but not enough to get close to that 112 figure. The Janata Dal Secular could end up playing either spoiler or kingmaker. Projected to bag between 34 and 43. Last time they had 40 seats. Expected now to bag between 34 and 43. Others between 4 and 7, which essentially means if a new government is to be formed in Karnataka, the only way this can happen is if the Janata Dal Secular combines with the Congress. At least that's what the percentages look like at this moment. Let's now show you the vote percent, because that's really where you pick up what the poll is saying. And what the poll is saying is that Karnataka is a tight-fought election with a gap of only 2% between the leading party, the Congress, coming in at 37%, the BJP coming in at 35%. Remember, the Congress had 37% vote share last time as well. They've largely held on. But it's the BJP that's jumping from 20 to 35%, a 15% increase, because last time there was the KJP, which had been set up by Yedurappa. This time, he's back in the BJP fold, taking the BJP tally up to 35, but still 2% less than the Congress. Then you've got the Janata Dal Secular, which was last time at 20, now 21%. This time, Rajdeep, at 19%, a 2% vote share gap. That's also the difference in the margin of error. 2% is also the margin of error. Very, very tight elections, Rajdeep.
That's right. It appears a very tight election from those numbers at the moment. Let's just get first reactions from my guests who are now joining me. Sambit Patra, the evergreen spokesperson of the BJP, is back. Mr. Channa, who's of Karvy, and they are the ones who've done the polls. And I keep repeating, if they get it wrong, they take the blame. If they get it right, we get the credit. Manisha Priyam, senior political analyst who's been traveling through Karnataka. Raj Chengappa, editorial director at India Today, Kannadiga, and someone who's tracked the state for years. Ajit Jha, editor research at India Today, also being joined by some of Karnataka's experts from Bengaluru. I'm joined by Professor Sandeep Shastri, Pro Vice Chancellor of Jain University. Ramakrishna Upadhyay, one of the senior most journalists in the state. Dinesh Gundu Rao of the Congress is also joining me at the moment, and Tanveer Ahmed, spokesperson JDS. Appreciate all of you joining us. I want, gentlemen, the first reactions to these poll numbers that we are getting. Let's start with you, Mr. Patra, because it appears that Karnataka could halt the BJP's juggernaut. At the moment, this is one of the few states where the Congress is ahead. Yes, they don't seem to have a majority as per our polls, but they are party number one in Karnataka as of now, as per our poll.
The castle will come down as far as Congress party in Karnataka is concerned, and the ATM of the Congress party would be closed. Because Amit Shah, the party president, has rightly pointed out, as far as Karnataka is concerned, that acts quote-unquote as the ATM for the Congress government. Mr. Rahul Gandhi goes there, withdraws money, comes back, so we are going to close that. Secondly, and most importantly, as far as the arithmetics of Karnataka election is concerned, I was talking to my good friend GVL Narasimha Rao, who is a cephalologist also, who was on your show just before that, and he advised me, and I have been studying the Karnataka election closely. 2008, I mean, what Mr. Rahul rightly pointed out was a close fight, the close context. 2008 election, the vote percentage that BJP had was 33.86%. Seat that it translated into was 110 seats. Congress 35.13%, and the seat that it got translated into was 80. So I firmly believe the major takeaway from this is that Congress is coming down from where it was. BJP is taking up from where it was. We are in a takeoff mode. They are in a crash landing mode.
I must learn from you how to get one-liners, how to even snatch victory from what appears at the moment a party in second place. You're giving the confidence of a front runner. But Dinesh Gundu Rao, there is something in what Sambit Patra says. It's not easy in Karnataka to translate vote shares into seats accurately. But traditionally, the BJP, where it wins in Karnataka, wins well. The Congress tends to win with thinner percentages and a more even spread. To that extent, this poll would suggest that this is a very close contest. Would you concede that the Congress's optimism that it will sweep Karnataka is certainly not going to come true?
See, if you see every opinion poll which has come out till date, Congress has either been seen to be the number one party or forming a majority on its own. So that's been the trend throughout across four to five opinion polls. And there is no anti-incumbency factor here. And we can see that the performance, the chief minister is by far the most popular compared to the others. And work has been done by the state government. We've given a stable government, a scandal-free government. We have given a government which is compared to Mr. Yedurappa's tenure as the most corrupt chief minister India has ever seen. And now he is back as a chief ministerial candidate. And Mr. Amit Shah and Mr. Sambit Patra talks about ATM when the most corrupt people of BJP are projected as chief ministers and future leaders of BJP
in
Karnataka.
Dinesh Gundu Rao, so I don't know where 37 and 35% is a 2% vote share gap
for the BJP today.
So, Mr. Rao, 2% vote share gap means this is a tight-fought election.
The fear that people will have when they see
the Congress in front
is that what if there is another Chola Bhatura moment?
Here my question, sir. What if there's another Manishankar Iyer waiting to crawl out of the woodwork? What if the Congress in the last lap self-implodes like we saw in Gujarat? You may have had a better chance if you hadn't scored the kind of self-goals in a tight-fought election. A better army generally tends to come together better.
See, in Gujarat, we were way behind and we caught up and we almost made it. In Karnataka, we are ahead and there's no anti-incumbency. And we have, who's campaigning in Karnataka today? Not Mr. Yediyurappa, it's Mr. Amit Shah who's campaigning. And he is turning out to be the star campaigner for Congress today because he is goofing up everywhere. There are people who are attacking him in his own rallies and in his own programs. And the more Amit Shah campaigns in Karnataka, it's good for us because the entire state leadership of BJP is more or less listless and defunct. And this has been taken over by the central leadership of the BJP.
Okay,
so we are confident. We are going. We have done very well in all the bi-polls recently, and we have done work. The most important part is we have given. And if you want stability in Karnataka today,
you know, I want to make it clear.
The only party which can form a government on its own is Congress, not BJP, not JDS.
We can come back to the anti-incumbency factor and whether you have actually worked as much as you claim, because our figures are very mixed on that. Certain areas you've done reasonably well, certain areas there are huge question marks. But you want a quick response, and then I want to get first reactions from all our panelists to the possibility that Karnataka is possibly throwing up, as per our figures, a hung assembly, which is very unusual at the moment in Indian state. Usually it's a winner-take-all syndrome in Indian state elections at the moment.
See, as far as the arithmetic is concerned, in my previous discussion, I have put that on the floor. But most importantly, I wanted to reply to what Mr. Dinesh Gundurao had said about Mr. Amit Shah. See, the Congress party trying to buy upon one of the four powers of Mr. Amit Shah, one of the slip of the tongues of Mr. Amit Shah when Mr. Yediyurappa was brought in. I would categorically ask him, why do you need that 9 seconds of Mr. Amit Shah's faupa? Why don't you have any 9 points of achievements? Why don't you say those 9 points of achievement in Karnataka?
If Rahul Gandhi had created a 9 second faupa, you would have gone on for it for 9 months. Allow them at least 1 week to go about it.
No, Rahul Gandhi is faupa incarnation in this world.
No, leave aside that.
But let's be on the point. Ask Mr. Dinesh Gundurao, does he have a list of 9 points of achievement in Karnataka? Why do they have to go into the kind of politics that we are seeing today, the quote unquote the Lingayat politics? All these in the last moment, it shows the nervousness. Nervousness is written large on the face.
Let's get reactions. You know, let's start across. Sandeep Shastri, you've been doing Karnataka elections longer than anyone else. Your first reactions. Do you see a hunger? Just a minute, Dinesh. Dinesh, let's not make it a Congress BJP tutu member. Let's get some first reactions to these poor big numbers that Rahul has given.
Is saying, when Ms. Amit Shah came, the Dalits opposed Ms. Amit Shah. His ministers have been making all kinds of statements against the Dalits, against the constitution. They are making rabble-rousing speeches. They are promoting hate and hate speeches. And he wants to talk about development. What did Mr. Narendra Modi speak in Gujarat? Did he speak about development? We want to speak about development. Today, Karnataka is the number one state in terms of investments, the highest job creators. We have done tremendous work for the weaker sections. And we want to talk about that. But all the BJP wants to talk about is communal angle, some false allegations.
This will become a tutu meme show. Let's stick to the numbers. I want to listen, Sambit. Okay. Let's listen to all our pundits and see what they have to make about the numbers. Sandeep Shastri, you're on the ground in Karnataka. Congress ahead, but not far enough to be able to form the government by itself. Do you think the JDS will be kingmaker? What's your reading, Sandeep Shastri?
Two quick points on this, Rahul. First, at this stage of the campaign, if we are seeing this type of trend, I think as the campaign picks on, you are likely to see one of the key players, Congress or BJP, surge ahead. So I'm not one of those who believes you're going to have a hung assembly, because we have had hung assemblies only when we are in transition, and Karnataka is not in transition. Point number two, if you look at the vote share that this survey shows, I think what's important to keep in mind is that the gap in the vote share is just 2 percentage points as per the survey. And I think this is a matter of alarm for the Congress, because if the vote share difference is only 2 percentage points, the BJP does not have a spread across the state but has a concentration. And if that vote difference is going to be only 2 percentage points, I think it's something the Congress needs to worry about, because remember,
in the 2008 elections when the BJP won, the Congress had a higher vote share. Let's remember that also. So a 2% vote share difference is something which is a matter of alarm if this were to be true.
But there is another matter of alarm which the Congress would be worried about, which is that all these numbers are coming before Narendra Modi comes really into the election campaign. The BJP's RSS network has already spread across Karnataka. At the booth level, the last mile connectivity has been seen in previous elections to benefit the BJP. So Raj Chengappa, is it now at the moment a really tight race that can go either way?
I agree. And if you look at what the BJP has done, successfully they've brought back Mr. Yedurappa, they've brought back Mr. Sriramalu, and that has in effect given them this boost that is there. Earlier down to 20%, they've up now to close to 35%, a very, very close fight. And I'm not surprised by these results, because this fact that the JDS would become the kingmaker in some senses with the numbers that it has, if the assemblies are hung as it is right now, is playing out as you see in the results. And I think the Congress, you're quite right, if Mr. Modi comes, there could be a major effect and tip the balance on this front. But also let's give credit to the Congress. You know, in an election where anti-incumbency should have been decisively being demonstrated, it has still retained its vote percentage, which means that Mr. Siddaramaiah and the Congress is doing something right. Let's look at the positive side of that one.
Because, you know, you haven't had a chief minister being re-elected in Karnataka since Ramakrishna Hegde in the mid-1980s. Yes, quick point, Manisha.
Rajdeep, here's a chief minister who's always been in election mode. I mean, if I remember any Kaveri verdict, whether it went in favor of Karnataka, it went in favor of Tamil Nadu, shutters were down, and he was literally called what is known as a Galata. Galata hota, Galata chief minister. He can, you know, do anything on the streets within minutes. On the other side, the assembly till the last days has worked till 11, 12 at night. Moment I would call up, people would say, assembly is working, and they would say, your parliament non-functional, Karnataka assembly is working. So he's been a person, in a sense, who's not really been, you know, who's not really been thinking that, okay, I have to fight the elections the last 3 years. He's been fighting it every time the Supreme Court has given a verdict. He's been fighting it every time somebody's gone to inaugurate the metro. So he's highly political, highly contentious on the ground.
We'll come in a moment to the JDS, who we've completely ignored and will probably hold the key to this election. But Ramakrishna Upadhyay, to understand from you, do you believe that Siddaramaiah versus Yediyurappa, is that the nature of the battle? Is it Congress versus BJP? Is it Modi versus Rahul? Because in our survey, we'll put up the numbers in a moment, clearly show that when it comes to chief ministerial choice, Siddaramaiah is ahead of his rivals. Is Yediyurappa a bit like L.K. Advani in 2009, a leader who has perhaps seen his best days?
Rajdeep, I want to make a quick point about the figures that you have put out. You know, if Congress is getting between 90 and 101, it's most worrying for that party. Because that means it's a hung assembly and they have to depend on JDS. You know, Congress and JDS would have been natural partners. But look at what they've done in the last 1 month. They've completely alienated JDS